Let's build this shop application here from scratch. And I advise everyone who already know about Flutter that he skips the setup section. And this is basically for all the beginners who never did some Flutter application. This video is sponsored by Invoice Ninja. Invoice Ninja is one of the largest open source platforms for invoicing. If you search for something to manage your invoices with Flutter and handle also your online payments, this service might be something for you. And to get started with this Invoice Ninja plugin, you find the link in the description box of this video. And here you can see we have different kind of views, a card view, and we also do really fancy animations here inside. So let's get started. We start here in our main Dart file and nothing is inside. The first thing what we need to do is to set here an importment statement. And this is needed to actually access all the widgets in Flutter. And then we create a main method. This is the main method of our application. And here we basically put the run app inside, and now we can add here all the widgets inside. So we create a new widget here inside. And basically in Flutter, everything is a widget. And we create then every time here a class with this widget. Now we want to define all the configurations for our app, so we can define a title, and this is a basic string, and then we need to override here a build method, and in Flutter every widget has a build method, so every stateless widget has here this build method. This material app here is a widget. Here you can set many properties inside, so we want to put here the title inside of our application, and then we also want to put here some theme data inside, and here we can basically define a primary color for our application, and everything has then here a deep orange color in our application by default. So we have many widgets in Flutter, and every widget gets then this color. And now we create here a home property. This is our first page, because right now our page is here black, and we want to create here a specific card page. So we want to start here with the card page, and here we want to build the different widgets inside, so we can have here different kind of articles inside of our list. We have here button to clear the card and so on. Now we want to start first of all with the file structure. So let's create first of all a folder named widget. And in Flutter everything is a widget, so we put here all of our widgets here inside. We also want to create a page folder, and here inside goes every time a whole page, and this consists then of many widgets, because like you can see also in our example here, we have different kind of pages. So this is one page, and this is another page, because here we have different content inside, and here you simply put all the pages inside. Let's also create here another folder which is called provider, and here we put our state management inside, so basically our whole logic of this application. Then we also create a data folder, and this data folder actually has all the data, all the strings what you see here inside, all of it is here inside of our data folder. And we also create here a transitions folder, and this is later for our animations which we are doing, and we put them here inside of this folder. Alright, now we have done already a major step forward. We have created all the folders, and now we can fill each of these folders with different files. And we want to start here with the card page, and like the name already says, we need to put it here inside of our page folder. So I simply create here a new file, and I call it chart and page, and then dart. So the first thing what you need to put here inside is the material widget. So this is basically in every class. Then we create here a class of chart page, and we make it extendable from stateless widget. So this was exactly like we did it here before. Everything in Flutter is a stateless widget. So we also name this stateless widget. Now you also need to override here again the build method, and here inside we can then put our UI inside. Before we start here with building this page, I also want to do some more configuration. So we go here down and create a new folder at our top level, and we call it assets. And here inside we want to put all the images used in our application. So we have, for example, here this image which is used, and we also have here other images which we want to put here inside. So I simply paste here all the images inside, and then we have here different kind of images which we want to use in our application. To make use of these images, you go to your pubspec jaml file, and it might be looking something different, so you have here a lot of comments maybe. However, you can remove all the comments which are inside, so simply remove all of them. And now you go then to this Flutter section, and here inside you can type assets, and here you define the folder. So we define here assets, and then simply we put here a slash afterwards, and then this folder is integrated in our app and we can make use of all of these images here inside. In this tutorial, we also want to make use of dependencies or plugins. And with this one, you get packages made by the community or by the Flutter team. And we want to use here two packages. So first of all, the sliding up panel. So simply go to pubdev and type it inside of the search. And then you get here to this package. And here you see inside the functionality what it consists. So here we have the sliding up panel, which we want to use in our application later. And we also want to use here the provider. And this is basically a state management tool. And with this one, you can basically manage all of your state easily and efficiently. And if you don't know how to use them, you go to the installing section and simply copy here this dependency. And you also do this with the second here. So you also copy this and then you put them simply here inside under your dependencies. And we put it here right now inside. And also do it with the other package. So put here also the provider inside and make sure that it looks like this. So there should be no space between, because here if you have some spaces, it doesn't work. After it, you need to hot restart your application. So close your application and simply start it again. Right now we have here an error. So let's quickly fix this error. I simply type here return container, and container is the basic widget in Flutter. And right now I see I have mispronounced this page. So it's called cart page instead. And then I need to import this. And now this application has no errors, like you can see. Here's nothing red, so you can start the application again. All right, now we have set up our whole application, and now we can actually start here to build this screen. And this is pretty easy. We will start here with some text at the top. Here's some button, and then we also put here later these articles inside. Let's get started in our build method, and our build method needs to return here every time a widget. And like you know already, everything in Flutter is a widget. And then you simply can return here this widget, the scaffold. And the scaffold is basically a widget which takes the whole space of our page. And this is basically defining every time a page with an app bar, with some bottom navigation bar and some other things in between. And here you can set, for example, the property background color. And then if I hot restart, you see that we have here this black color instead. And now we want to build here actually this white text on top of it. So we want to start actually with this text and this button here. So I create here a body property. This is every time the content of our page. And here inside we put a column, and a column is basically placing many widgets under each other. And here we can then define a row, and the row is the opposite of the column. Instead of showing all our widgets vertically, we show them horizontally. And what we want to do here now is to put here a cart inside, because this is horizontally, and also this button. So I create here a text object, and here you put a string inside. And now we can try this out, so you can hot restart or hot reload your application. And you wouldn't see it right now because we have set our background color to black. And by default, this text has a color of black. However, if I comment this background color out, you see that we have here in the top left corner this text. And that's already really good. So I put the color again inside. And now we want to change here basically this text color so that it gets white. And therefore we have here a style and text style property where you can change how this text should look like. And here we can set a font weight so we can make this text in bold. And we also can give here a color so we make it white. And it is still here at the top. However, you can also set here font size and make it a bit bigger. And now you see here much more of the text. And next to the text, we want to place here this button. And this is also pretty easy. So we create here a new widget. So this was one widget, and we create here another one, which is called flat button. And here inside, you basically can create a text object. So every time if you have a child property, you can put another widget inside. And we use here this text widget. And the flat button is not completed yet because we need here some other field, and we need to define here also this onPressed, and then it should display here this button. However, here we have the same problem. The text color of this button is black, so we can also change it here with text color and put it to white. And then we have here this button, and you can click on it, and then you can add some functionality to it. And now we want to get this text and button more down so that we see it here more clearly. And therefore I go here to the column. So we have here this row where we put these both widgets inside next to each other. And in the column you can place widgets under each other. And here we put some spacing in between. So we put here some spacing at the top and then our widgets. So I put here a size box and a height of 30. And here basically we define a 30 pixels of height, and then comes our row, and we display here the text widget and the button widget. If you now look here at our example, you see that we have here this text and the button. However, we also want to have some spacing on the left side and on the right side. And in Flutter, how you can do this is you simply can wrap around your column. So around all of our widgets, we put a padding around. And here you can define a spacing which is going here into all directions right now. So we define here a spacing on the left side, on the top side, on the right side, and on the bottom side. And I simply hot reload so you see what I mean. So we have right now here 28 pixels of spacing. And here on the right side we also have 28 pixels of spacing. And also on the bottom and on the top we also have 28. And you can basically change this value, and if you put a higher value inside, then we get here more spacing to the left side, also to the top and to the bottom and the right. Now we want also to have here some space between our text and our button, so we want to have here the maximum space between. And how we can do this easily is we go here to our row, which is displaying these both widgets next to each other. And here you have another property which is called main axis alignment. And here we set space between. So what it will do is to put here space between our widgets, and I simply hot reload and you see that we have here now the maximum space between both of these widgets. And now it already looks pretty good, the UI, like you can see. We have already created this header, and now we want to move forward and create also more advanced widgets where we also load images, where we again show here different text and also align them here properly inside of our design. To build these articles, we start here again in our column, and here we have the whole list of our widgets, and basically we already have here our row, and below our row we want to put these cart items inside. So I create here this method, and I also create here a new method where we actually return again a widget, because everything in Flutter is a widget. And this time we want to return again a text. So we return here the text of cart is empty, and we also set here a text style. So we set here again the color of white and also a higher font size. And if we do this, you see that we have here this text inside. And this looks already pretty good, because if we have the case that we have no articles inside, then we want to simply display here this text. And later, if we have articles inside, then we want to display here this inside. By default, our items, which we placed here in our cart items inside, should get the whole space. And we also want to center here this text more here in the middle. Therefore, we wrap this build cart items inside of an expanded widget. And here, if we do this, we tell this widget that it should get here the whole space until the end of our page. And this expanded widget can be every time used if you have a column wrapped around. So make sure that you have here the column around, or you can also put it inside of a children property of a row. Right now, if I hot reload, you see no changes. However, I can tell you that this takes here the whole space, so we can also wrap here another widget around, which is a basic container. And here a container has another property which is called color, and here you can set, for example, a color of green inside, and then you see that our widget here takes the space until the bottom. And now what we want to do is to place this text here inside of our middle. So I simply put here around our text widget a center widget inside. And like the name says, it will then center this text here inside of this green widget which you see here. And now if I hot reload, you see that this widget is centered and the center widget will also get here the whole width by default. Let's continue here with our design, and right now it might be even more interesting to put here this text and also the button inside, because we right now use here this expanded widget and now we can easily put here these other things below at the bottom. And because we want to build the new widgets here below our widget, we go here again to our column, because this widget is displaying all the widgets under each other. And here we go to the list, and then you simply go to the end of the list, and here we want to create our new widget inside. So I simply put here a new widget inside with some spacing, and if I hot reload, you see that we get here some more spacing, like 16 pixels, and after it we want to display our new widgets. So I put here a row inside so that we can display multiple widgets next to each other. And now, like before, we put here again two widgets inside. So here we have also two widgets. And we also want to set here the maximum space between these two widgets. And like before, we also use here the main axis alignment space between to have here two widgets inside. And the maximum space is between these widgets. And after it, we put the children property inside. And now we can place here all the widgets inside, which should be displayed next to each other. Let's get started with this text here, and then we also build here this bigger text. So we create here a text object and call it here total, and inside we give it some text style, so we give it a white color and a higher font size, and then it will look like this. So we have here between this widget some spacing, and this is exactly 16 pixels. And now next to the total, we want to also display here on the end this other text, and here we put our dollar sign inside, and in front we have an escape character, because you need to escape this dollar sha. If you don't do this, you see like we get here an error, and he tries to interpret this here as a variable or something. Therefore, make always sure that you escape this dollar sign and put here backslash in front. Alright, let's also set here a text style. So we set here again a white color and some font size, which is bigger, and also a bold font weight. And then it looks like this, and this looks already pretty cool. The next thing is we want to build here this big button, and also we have here again some spacing between these. So we go simply after our row, and here we are still inside of the column to display another widget under this widget. Here we simply create some spacing between this widget and the other widget which we want to create. So I add here 24 pixels more spacing, and after it we want to put our button inside, and this time it's a raise button. So last time we used here this flat button, and the flat button doesn't have here any shape, so you don't see that it is a button, and this raise button you see that it is a button. And here you put also text inside, so we put here for example a text of next inside, and again we set some style. So again, put here some color of white inside and so on. Now you see that we have here this button already here inside. However, you don't see this button right now. So what we also want to add is an onPressed function. And this is later used if you want to actually do some functionality if you click on this button. And now if I hot reload, you see that we have here this button visible, and you see it's clearly a different button than this one, because this button has here shape. And we also want to change the color of this button, so I put here a different color inside, and this comes from our theme. So we have here in our main page this primary color defined, and this primary color goes here inside, basically. If we now look here at our design, what we want to accomplish, you see that this button is more rounded than this button, and what you do therefore is you simply can go to your raise button, and here you have a field shape. And here you can define the shape of this button. So we call here stadium border, and then you see that we have here this rounded button. Let's also change the width and height of this button. So we want to give it the maximum width and also some height. So we go again to our button and wrap it around a container. And the container is a really basic widget in Flutter. So what we use here is the width property and the height property. And we set first of all the height property. And now look at the button. If I hot reload, you see that we have here more pixels than height. And basically you can define here some other height. And then this button changes here and gets 80 pixels of height. Let's put it again back to 50, and I also want that it stretches here to the maximum amount. So we put here a width inside, and you can simply say double infinity to stretch it completely until here. And because we have here a padding around our widgets, so we have defined here in the beginning some padding, which is going here around our column, which places all of these widgets under each other. And therefore, if we now hot reload, you see that it only goes until this location. And if you don't have this padding inside, then all of them will take here the maximum space. So let's put again the padding inside, and then this design looks much better. Alright, now we have already accomplished a lot, and now we simply want to build here these article items with an image in front and so on. And we start here first of all with one item. So let's go to this text card is empty in our app, and here it is inside. And I simply will comment this right now out. And instead we want to build here inside now a specific article. This time we want to return here a new widget, and we call it build card item. So we create a new method, and this method again returns also a widget. And here inside we return now a list tile widget, and this widget is a pretty cool widget. So basically you have here three stages, the leading stage, the title stage, and the trailing stage. And basically we can now put here an image inside, then we put here some text inside, and in the third stage we put here also text inside. The first stage is the leading stage, and then you put here something at the beginning of your widget. And here we set a circle avatar, and the circle avatar is exactly this rounded widget. And here inside we want to display image. So what we do here is to call the property background image. And now we need to define here some image of our assets. So like you remember, we have here in our assets all of these images inside. And now we can simply refer to one of these. So we type here asset image and put here our assets name inside, which is this folder, and then we take here one image, and this is exactly this image here. So make sure that everything is typed here correctly, otherwise the image wouldn't display here inside of our app. And now if I hot reload, you see that we have here our image inside, and this is exactly this image which we have here in our assets. Let's go further and also create here this text of the description of this article. So we have here the second stage, our title, and we put here a row inside because we have here two texts basically inside. So we have here the quantity, and then we have some space, and then we have the title. And this title has also a different font weight, like you can see. So this is like appearing in a bigger font size. So here we start first of all with the first text, which is our quantity, how many items are inside of this list. And here we have one, and we also set again a text style. After it, we have some spacing and show them the title. So I put here a size box of width inside. So we have here 10 pixels between this text and the other text. And here we put our second text inside. So I put here this title inside, and we also put here text style like before inside, and put here a color of white inside. And this looks then like this. However, now you could imagine if this title is here much longer. So let's say we have here a drink, which is a long title. So let's put here a text inside, which is longer. And if I hot reload, you see that here happens something really weird. So basically it's trying to get here more space than it could have. And to actually fix this error, you can wrap this text inside of another widget, which is called expanded. And this will care that this text gets in enough space. So basically the text will wrap to the new line and will show the remaining words here inside. However, for our case, we only want to show one line, and therefore you have here also inside of your text widget another one which is called overflow. And here you can set that the text overflow should have some dots after it if there's some overflow, and it looks like this. And you could also set here a property inside of max lines, so you can define here how many lines this text should get. maximum and we put it here to 1. And if you set it, for example, to 2, then you can display here much more text inside. And if I type here more, then you see everything is fine. And then the dots will appear here at the second line. Alright, we put it again to 1 line and then it looks like this. And we will also remove here all this text. The last thing which we need to put here inside is this price, and that's what we want to place here at the end. And therefore we go here again to our list tile. So we have set here the first stage and the title was the second stage. And now comes the third stage, and here we simply put a trailing attribute inside of our list tile. And here we basically define again a text and we also escape here our dollar sign again. And let's also put here a text style inside. And then it looks like this. Alright, now we have done already a major step. So we have displayed here our first item inside. And now we want to display here also multiple items inside. To create here more items inside of our list, we create here again a new folder. And this is one which I forgot in the beginning. So we also need to set here this model folder. And then we create here a new file. And we call it cartItem.dart. And here inside we first of all create an importment statement, so we want to create later some required statements, and I will go more into it later. So let's create here a class, and inside of this class we want to store all of these fields which this item here has. So basically we have here a quantity, we have some title, we have some price of our cart item and so on. We also have here this URL image, and that's all what we want to put here inside. And we begin here with the title and make it a string as the type, because here we put every time a string inside. And then we also create here other types, so we add here quantity, and this is basically a number, therefore we take here int. We also have a price, and this is a double because this can be also a number which has some comma and some more precise value after it, and therefore we use here this double. And we also have here the image URL, which is this image here, and we also put here an ID for this object inside. Here inside of this model, we want to create now a constructor to give all of these fields here a value, and therefore we create here this constructor which has the same name as our class, and we put here all of these fields inside. And every time we have here this in front, and this will then put this attribute which we later give here inside to this variable here. And this is basically an immutable widget. So here we have every time a final in front, and this makes it then not changeable, this object anymore. And therefore we will create right now a new method to actually change this model here. So let's create here a new method, and this is called copy. And with this one, you can later change this model object. So we put here this ID inside. This is the first field. And now we will look at how this copying is working with this ID field. And then we call here all the parameters which we have here inside. And first of all, we will call here this ID and put our new object here inside. So I put here this ID inside, which we define here in our method. And in case we don't define here this value ID, then we want to actually put the current ID inside. So we put here this field, which we already have here initially inside. And to make sure that we always have here initially a value inside, we make use here of this @required statement, and we put it in front of all of these values inside. So this item can be only created and initialized with some values. And now every time we have then here this value of ID and can put here this value inside in case we don't put here inside of this method this ID value. We will later look more closely at what this is doing. Alright, and now we create here all the other fields. So we create here these fields which we have here at the top so that we also can modify them later. And then we do here again the same thing as we did with the ID. Then we also put here all the other fields inside. Alright, now let's go back here again to our page. So we go here to this cart page, and now we want to make use of this model object which we have created. So we write here inside of this method as a parameter here cart item, and here we give it a name of cart item, and then you need to import here this model class which we have created before, and then he has added here this importment state at the beginning. And here inside of this method, we need to define here right now this cart item every time. And now we can define here every field which we have put here inside. So we put here this ID inside, the title, some description, a price, and also the image URL, which points here exactly to this image here in our file system. And then we go to our build cart item. And here inside, we want to make use now of these fields which we have created here at the top. So instead of this hard-coded text, we put here actually our cart item inside, and then we want to access here our image URL, and I need to also put it here in the right spelling, and then we put here every time this image URL here inside, and we also want to do it here for the other fields. So we want to use here the quantity and put here the quantity inside, and because this is here an integer object, this doesn't work right now, because here for this text it is required to have a string, and therefore we make it here as a string and simply wrap here the string around. And now we want to interpret this here as a value instead as of a text. So here we use this dollar sign, and then you use here some curly braces and put it around, and then this here is interpreted as this value instead. And this technique is called string interpolation. Let's also go forward quickly. So we have here this text, and instead we show here from our cart item the title, and instead of this trailing text, we want to show our price. So we put here again our cart price inside, again put here some dollar sign before, and then we put here the curly braces around this object, and now it is interpreted as an object. And this looks a little bit funny, so basically we have two dollar signs. One is the dollar sign which will be displayed as a text, and the other one is for the string interpolation. And now we also want to put here an x after our quantity, because if you hot reload, you see that we have here no x after our quantity, and that's what we want to change. So we have here now this x every time inside, and now our item looks here perfect, and we can now build here many items inside. To place now multiple items under each other, we can use again the column like we have learned before. And here we can now put again some widgets inside. So we create here the first widget, and you simply can copy and paste here another widget inside. And then we have here multiple widgets inside, and you can simply put here many inside. And this looks then like this. And if I put here another item inside, you see that we get here again this layout issue, because we try to put here more inside than this green box can hold. And to change to this, we can also put here something inside like a list view. And the list view is exactly the same as a column, only this space here, this green space, is then scrollable. And this looks then like this, so we can basically scroll here around and all of our widgets are displayed here inside. Right now we give it here every time, every article, the same name. However, you can also change here this data every time and put here other information inside. Now we want to look at how we can store these kind of data more efficiently, because right now it takes here a lot of space inside of our class, and that's what we want to change. So let's go here to our provider folder and create a new file, and we call it here shop provider. And here inside we want to place all of our logic of this application inside, and we also want to put here all our data inside as objects. Here inside we want to first of all put some importment statements inside. So we import here Flutter, and also here we import the cart item which we have created before. And then we put here this with change notifier inside, and with this one we define here that this is our provider, and then we can later use it inside of our app and refer to this shop provider. Here inside we want to store all of our data, and we do it in a map, and a map always has a key and a value, and here we put then these items to an initial value, so in the beginning our map is empty. Then we also want to create a getter and setter, because this is by default private, so no one can access this outside of this class. And we want to put here this items, which is public inside, and return here our items. And we also create here a setter method, and here we basically put our new value inside, and then we can modify this items here to this new value. Let's go here back to our cart page and let's take here one of these model items which we have defined here, and let's extract it and put it here to our shop provider. And here we will now simply put it right now inside. So here you need to set a key value pair, and as a beginning we put a string inside, and then we put here our cart item inside, and then it looks like this. And here we will simply put our ID inside for right now. And let's create here maybe also a second object. So I simply copy here this new object and paste it here inside, and then I changed here these values to another article. And now we have done already a really major step, because we can now use here this shop provider inside of our app, and then also can put here all of our logic later inside of this application. Let's go back to our cart page. And now we want to remove first of all of these items because they are not needed anymore. And then it looks like this, and I can also hot reload and we have no item here inside. For now it is fine. And now we want to call here this shop provider. So we want to get this provider which we have created before. And then you also need to do all the importment statements. So you need to import the shop provider, and we also need to import here this provider. And this comes from the package provider, which we have set initially inside of our plugins. And to make this provider working, we also need to do some other thing. So we need to go to our main file. And here basically we need to import this provider package and also this shop provider, which we have created before. And now we need to initialize it here inside of our app, and we do it here at the root of our app. So at the beginning of our app, we define here this shop provider, and this will then initialize here our objects and put them all inside of our map. And then we can go here again back and use this state. So we need to wrap here around our material app another widget, which is called change notifier provider. And here we need to put the state inside. So we have here this create and put here our state inside. And this is needed to actually later access this state object, which we have stored here inside of our widgets. So now we can go again to our cart page, and this will then get us this shop provider, which is stored here at our main level. And here we can now access all these items. So we have here this provider items, which is our maps of string and carts. And here we want to get the values. So we want to get this cart items only. Now we want to call on each of these cart items this build cart item method, like we have done it before. And therefore we use here the map functionality and put here our build cart item inside. So we go over all of these values which we have here stored in our cart list item, and we go over all of them and map them to a widget. So basically this is getting here our cart item, this map function, and puts it here directly inside of this method, and then returns here a widget. And then we also need to make it here a list. And now everything should work here fine. So let's try this out, this application. And you see that if we hot restart, that we have here these two items inside, which we have defined here in our shop provider. And to complete this design here on the right side, we want to make sure that we also show here this other text inside again. And every time if we have no items, so we can check here with an if statement, if we have no items and if our list is empty, then we want to actually put here this text inside, and we command this here again out. And this is the case if our list is empty, then we show that our cart is empty, and otherwise we return here this list view, which is a scrollable column, and here we put all of our items inside. And now we can go to our shop provider and try this out. So I should simply remove here all of these items quickly. And if I do this and then I hot restart, then you should see here that our cart is empty. However, if we have here items inside and if we then hot restart, then we should see here all of these items inside, which we have placed here inside. And now we go again to our cart page, and then we want to remove here this color green, which you see here as the color. And if we do this, then we have here our design finished. And if you look here at our goal, you see that you have completed your first design. Only one little change we need to change here. So we also need to change here the background color, because right now it is by default blue and we want to change it to a white color. Therefore, we go to our main file, and here inside we have here the seam data, and here we have set our primary color, and here inside we want to set the primary color dark, and we set it to white. And if we do this, you see that we have here a white background for our images. And by the way, you can get this whole application and the source code of this application with the first link in the description. And with the second link, you can get my Flutter course, where I teach you how you can become a more efficient Flutter developer. And as a hint, Invoice Ninja has built an app with Flutter for managing invoices, and this Flutter app is open source and you can check it out, this app and also the source code on GitHub. Hello everyone, thank you so much for watching this video. Please make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel here to get the latest news about Flutter, and see you soon, bye!